As of April 13th of 2025, there are currently 48 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is the same number as were erupting last week. One of these complexes is Italy's famed Mount Stromboli, which since it has been near continuously erupting for the last 5,000 years, has been nicknamed the Lighthouse of the Mediterranean. This is owed largely to the fact that its persistent orange glow is often visible from a fair distance. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Alaska, multiple volcanic ash advisories were issued regarding the towering Mount Katmai volcano, which has not erupted in more than a century, and yet, this volcano didn't erupt this week. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, the Gede volcano was closed for multiple additional days due to an unexpected strong earthquake storm, including an earthquake which seemingly indicated magma movement. This marked Gede's first episode of unrest in more than 30 years. And, in what is this week's top story, the Kanlaon volcano produced a large eruption, generating pyroclastic flows and surges. This eruption occurred at 5:51 a.m. local time on April 8th, when building pressure and volatiles broke through overlying rock. This sent a plume of ash rapidly upwards into the atmosphere, but at the same time, part of the eruption column collapsed back to the ground, generating pyroclastic flows and surges. These moved at up to 142 kilometers per hour, reaching up to 1,100 meters downslope before coming to a halt. Additionally, thrown lava bombs started multiple grass fires, making it incorrectly look like fissures had opened up on Kanlaon's flanks. The eruption in question continued for 56 minutes until ceasing at 6:47 a.m. local time on the same day. Ash reached a maximum altitude of 6,706 meters or 22,000 feet, and the specific explosion probably had a volcanic explosivity index of a 2. Here are the areas minor ashfall was reported to have fallen in, and here are the areas a sulfurous smell was detected by residents, likely due to low but elevated levels of sulfur dioxide and/or hydrogen sulfide gas. While still fairly small in the context of explosive eruptions at world volcanoes, April 8th's eruption was quite large in the context of specifically the Kanlaon volcano, marking its third largest eruption on record. Surprisingly, no intermittent weaker ash emissions have occurred in the 4 days since, so it is unknown if this type of activity, which had been ongoing for 5.5 months, will resume. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, on the island of Java, the Gede volcano, which has not erupted since 1957, produced a brief yet intense episode of unrest. Whereas normally this volcano would produce close to zero earthquakes a day, on April 1st, approximately 50 earthquakes were detected. 5 days later, a tornado earthquake was detected, indicating magma movement. All of these events occurred at fairly deep depths, suggesting a potential resupply of magma underground in a manner which has been centered beneath Wadon Crater. Gede typically erupts semi-frequently for multiple years to decades, only to be followed by decades of inactivity. We happen to be in its second longest quiet period, only surpassed by its lack of eruptions between 1762 and 1831. And, in Alaska, volcanic ash advisories were issued for the Katmai volcano for 4 consecutive days from April 6th through 9th, and this was despite the fact that it did not actually erupt. So, were these reports wrong? No. Instead, after a very large explosive volcanic eruption ends, for years and sometimes decades or longer, strong winds from time to time can pick up loose ash still on the ground and remobilize a portion of it into the air. This is what occurred here in relation to not the Katmai volcano, but rather the Novarupta volcano, which produced the largest single explosive volcanic eruption of the 20th century. Both its thick pyroclastic flow deposits, which are up to 500 feet thick, and its several feet thick ash beds from the 1912 eruption are frequently remobilized during the spring and fall during high wind events. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on April 12th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Laser Girl, for supporting my work.